images have emerged of a new unmanned variant of Joint Light Tactical Vehicle armed with Naval Strike Missile. The system is currently under development for the U.S. Marine Corps. This initiative is part of a larger plan to reconstruct the surface. The test was conducted in November 2020, but no pictures were released at that time. Raytheon has released the pictures on the 28th of April, which is credited to the U.S. Navy. The system is officially known as the Navy-Marine Expeditionary Ship Interdiction System, NMESIS. Kim Ernzen, Vice President of Naval Power at Raytheon Missiles and Defense, said in the press release that went along with the new picture of the NMESIS, "Our naval strike missile is a vital weapon for denying enemies the use of key maritime terrain. This test further demonstrates our partnership for advancing the Marine Corps' modernization priorities and enabling sea control and denial operations." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. Marine Corps will deploy NMESIS with Naval Strike Missile to deter adversaries. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. The U.S. Marine Corps had stated last year that it is not optimized to meet the demands of the National Defense Strategy. The service plans to embark on a 10-year transformation plan that could see many radical changes, including ditching of its entire tank force. The plan is in line with the view that U.S. Marines will have to fight in small groups and in a distributed manner in any major conflict going forward. The service also identifies China as the pacing threat to the U.S. and its allies in the coming years. Most analysts believe that in the event of a conflict between the two countries, the South China Sea will be a major theater of war. In case the dispute escalates to a war, one of the jobs of the Marine Corps will be to capture the islands in the South China Sea, which have been militarized. The islands are relatively small. For example, Fiery Cross Reef is only about 680 acres. Though China has maintained that it does not intend to pursue militarization, satellite imagery says different. China has excavated deep channels, created and dredged harbors, and constructed communications logistics and intelligence gathering facilities in the several islands. Large hardened airfields and hangars suitable for military operations have been constructed. Corps Commandant General David Berger told the House Armed Services Committee in this context, "I think every service chief would love to have a better force, but you need us to be lethal, you need us to be mobile, you need us to be integrated with the Navy, so we're going to reduce the size of the Marine Corps sometime this year, more next year." A complete NMESIS system consists of the Unmanned Joint Light Tactical Vehicle, JLTV, also known as the Remotely Operated Ground Unit, Expeditionary Fires, Rogue Fires, and a launcher with two ready-to-fire Naval Strike Missiles, NSM, inside their self-contained launch canisters. While limited details are available for the Rogue Fires vehicle, it will most likely utilize an unmodified 4x4 JLTV chassis. Viewers may note that Oshkosh was declared the winner on the 25th of August 2015 when its JLTV model was selected over Lockheed Martin and AM General's models. JLTV is as much of a technology leap over the Humvee as the Humvee was to the Jeep-like Ford M151 Mutt before it. According to the U.S. Army, an infantry brigade combat team in the 10th Mountain Division at Fort Drum was the first to receive JLTV in June 2017. The JLTV family has many configurations: heavy guns carrier, utility, general purpose, close combat weapons carrier. Naval Strike Missile, or NSM, is the upgrade of Kongsberg's Penguin short to medium range anti-ship guided missile. The missile has a range of 100 miles or 185 kilometers. NSM is a fifth generation missile capable of high subsonic speeds. It has sea skim mode, by which it travels very close to the surface and has a stealthy profile, making it hard to detect and intercept. It's equipped with 276 pounds or 125 kilograms multi-purpose blast fragmentation warhead. NSM features an imaging IR seeker, which is complemented by inertial GPS navigation. The missile also has a built-in database of representative ship types to distinguish between intended targets and other objects. Importantly, it can be used as an anti-ship missile as well as for taking out land targets. Kongsberg does offer NSM in a ground launch configuration, with the missiles being mounted on tactical trucks. Change is the only constant, and this is especially true when it comes to modern warfare, which is evolving at a rapid pace. The plan by U.S. Marine Corps, if implemented, will see it optimize itself to face the changing dynamics. It's to be noted that unmanned launch vehicles, networked together, could be employed in small groups, and these can bring lethal fire to a significantly large area. The operator and the launcher could be deployed in a distributed manner and be much more mobile and flexible. This will mean the rival won't be able to target them easily and in a decisive manner. The key concept is to be able to rapidly deploy Marines to establish forward bases across a broad area of operations, and then they'll rapidly position themselves as per the tactical situation in the battle space. NMESIS could then be utilized to deter rivals' naval forces from moving into adjacent waters. It'll be interesting to see how things pan out in the coming days. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.